Good morning, folks. 21st Century Caveman here. Hope everybody's safe. Hope everybody's well. So here you can see the fruits of my recent labour, which resulted in the acquisition of a number of concrete slabs from another property. So I've removed all of the blobs on the underside of the concrete slabs and brought them back for use elsewhere. So these slabs then were down for many years and are very, very dirty, but for the most part they're still in pretty good condition. However, they're in desperate need of a good clean, and this is the whole point of the video. So the first thing to do then is to clean off any surface dirt. Now, you don't need a pressure washer or anything, a normal hose pipe will do. And yes, just in case you're wondering, I am using a hose pipe. So once you've cleaned up the slabs the best you can, we now need to move on to the secret ingredient. So we need to get our hands on some sodium hypochlorite. Now at this stage it's important to make it clear that this needn't be a highly complex mind-numbing procedure which requires lots of analysis and mental gymnastics. However, it is fair to say that there's a hard way and an easy way of doing this. Now, if you want to put yourself through the ringer, the hardest way to obtain the secret ingredient is to get some molecules, and you'll need one molecule of sodium, one molecule of oxygen, and another of chlorine. And that will give you the secret ingredient, and the chemical name for this is NaOCl. So once you've managed to find these molecules, separate them, you've then got to stick them together, which, to be fair, will be easier said than done. Alternatively, you can just get yourself down to your local store and buy a few tubs of bleach. However, it's fair to say that all bleach is not made equally, and it does come in different strengths. So typically then you can buy either thin bleach or thick bleach. So the difference then will be in the concentration of the bleach. So as we can see then, we've got some thin bleach on the left hand side, and when we look at the ingredients it has 0.8% chlorine, so in other words the concentration is less than 1%, compared with the thick bleach on the right hand side, which is 4.3% chlorine. So clearly the bleach on the left, the thick bleach, is 4 or 5 times more powerful than the one on the left hand side. So here we have a 6-litre watering can, approximately a third full of water. So just by way of comparison then, we're just going to sort of, you know, see which ratios of bleach to water work the best. So initially then I'm just going to use a 1-to-1 ratio of thin bleach to water to see if it's any good. Now when we put it on the slabs, we will notice that it does look very thin, it's sprinkled on, and it's fair to say that it just looks like water, doesn't it, basically. However, if we put on a thicker solution, which we've got now, you'll see that it's starting to sort of froth up a bit, which suggests that the concentration is a lot higher. So because I'm an impatient person, I just decided to get some of the thick bleach, just pour it on basically in its concentrated version, and as you can see it's foaming up very, very quickly. It's a very thick solution, so it's not running away like the thinner solution. So clearly this is going to do a much better job of cleaning these slabs. So you can see in the video here that I've got a very stiff brush, so I'm giving it a good old scrub basically, no need to go on your hands and knees. And we can see that this stuff is sitting on there very well indeed, and I'm very confident this is going to work, and we're going to get a good result on this. So I think my recommendations are that if you buy thin bleach, then basically just pour it on neat. If you're using the thicker stuff, in order to use it economically, I would suggest using 1 ratio of bleach to say 2 or 3 ratios to water. So look, we're giving these slabs a good old scrub, and then we'll come back to them a little bit later and see how they're faring. Okay, so 30 minutes later, these are starting to come up quite nice then. So this job will have cost me about 75p to clean up these slabs. So what we'll do, I'm just going to have some tea, a glass of wine, and then I'm going to come back to this in about an hour. Rinse them off and see what we're left with. But I think they're going to be quite good actually. I think they're going to come up well. And if there are still lots of black spots, that sort of thing, then guess what, we'll just do it again. It's no biggie, is it? Right guys, 1.5 hours later, and these look as if they've come up really, really nice. So I'm just going to wash them down now with a hose. Don't need a pressure wash or anything like that. Normal hose will do. So I reckon they've come up a treat. But then of course we should check them tomorrow morning and see what they're like. So I think that's a success, and it's cost me no more than 70 odd p. So we're just going to work these down one more time then for good luck. And the reason is quite simply because you don't really want to leave much concentration of bleach on these. It's not going to have a major detrimental effect on the integrity of the concrete blocks, but if you do this on a regular basis, it may well be the case that it weakens them. Now for my purposes, I'm simply going to use these as a small patio area outside the man cave or workshop, so there isn't going to be any massive weight on there, up on my fat ass basically. But if cleaning these sorts of slabs, or indeed any concrete on a regular basis, so for example on a driveway and you are parking a vehicle, then you know they need washing down properly just in case it does weaken them. Right guys, okay, so 24 hours later, I think these slabs have come up quite nice. So for 70 odd p, I think that's certainly been a success. And it's certainly a hell of a lot cheaper than buying new slabs when I've got these old ones, which were down for years actually, I'm led to believe, from one of the neighbours. So yeah, 70 odd p, I think that's a bargain basically. Especially when you're bearing the cost of some of these proprietary concrete cleaning solution. Absolutely ridiculous. There we go, look, 70 odd p. Job's a good one. Done. Boom. And obviously if you wanted to be extremely meticulous, you could just go over these again, look. But I'm not going to bother, it's not necessary for my purposes. The fact is they look a hell of a lot better than they did when I started 24 hours ago. As far as I'm concerned, that's the job well done.